seeking an injunction. We're going to, so it's at the judge is looking at the temporary injunction. We are still pursuing the permanent injunction. We haven't received a court date yet. I mean, we believe, so it's Uber Canada that is actually offering the service, and we believe they're in violation of the bylaw, and we believe that there are some issues associated with how they're operating, including public safety risks. We have an enforcement program that we will continue to operate, and we certainly don't intend to single out any particular group or organization. Our goal is to enforce against all drivers who are not compliant with the vehicle for hire by.
So the bylaw itself, council has actually asked us to take a look at the bylaw and to have some discussions with various types of service offerings to determine whether or not there might be a way to bring forward. And so we have been having discussions with a few different companies about what those amendments might look like.
What's the deterrent here? You're not aggressively going after Uber drivers, and we've been told by drivers that Uber pays for these $49 fines. What's the deterrent here right now for drivers?
And that's absolutely a challenge. I think that we have talked to other municipalities in terms of what they've been doing. For example, we've heard in cities in central Canada that have been impounding vehicles. And whether or not that's an appropriate action given our regulatory framework, we don't know, but that's certainly an option.